Today on Fast Friday, I'm going to show you a great way to quickly cull through all of your Fujifilm RAW files. I'm serious. It is so much stronger, better, and faster than doing it in Lightroom or Capture One.
Better. Stronger. Faster.
Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. If you shoot in RAW format on Fujifilm cameras, particularly with RAW uncompressed files, you're likely looking at having to cull through hundreds of image files, each one almost 60 megabytes each. Time is money, and the faster that you can get through this culling process, the more that you'll increase the efficiency of your workflow and decrease the overhead cost of doing business. Now, once you finish your photo shoot, got it! And now you have to complete the three main parts of your workflow: culling, editing, and delivery. Now, being able to speed up the editing and delivery parts generally comes only with time and experience, often many years of experience. However, with regard to the culling process, you can speed that up by using a program that's dedicated to the fast viewing and rating of RAW files. There are two such programs, Photo Mechanic and Fast RAW Viewer. Now, both are excellent. However, up until now, I had not really ever used Fast RAW Viewer. Oh, wow. I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here. First, a disclaimer. Fast RAW Viewer did not sponsor this video. They have no idea who I am and that I'm making this video today. I paid for the software and my opinion is my own. As of the date of this video, Fast RAW Viewer is a one-time payment of $24. They also have a free, fully functional version that you can download and try out for 30 days. I will put a link to that in the description down below this video. I'm not going to be covering the advanced features today of this program because this is not a tutorial, but I do recommend you check out their help guide. Okay, I have right here a folder filled with Fujifilm uncompressed RAW files. And there are 1,345 of them. And each one is around 58 megabytes in size. Now, I have taken all these RAW files already off of this SD card that was on the camera, and I put them on the desktop of this computer. But also, to be clear, you can put the SD card right in this computer and go ahead and start culling through the photos that way if you wanted to. I think it's a better idea to make a copy of it, get it off the SD card and onto the computer. I'm going to now drag the folder from my desktop into the program. This is being done in real time. I am not speeding this video up at all. 3, 2, 1, and drop. Look at that. Did you see how fast that is? It was like, right? All right, let me jump down. Watch this. I'm going all the way down to the very bottom. Boom. Look at that! Have a look at that! Here's the middle, boom! Look at this! The minute you pull up a section of it, they just appear immediately. It is so fast. And it's done. Now, everyone has a different way that they cull through their photos. My way is I first go through and delete any crappy shots, right? Delete the bad ones. That's the first thing I do. And I literally just delete, 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 delete. That's what I do. Now, the way this program works, when you delete a photo, it doesn't delete it off the computer. It puts it in a special folder. In this case, the default name of the folder is underscore rejected, but you can rename that to anything you want. So for example, I'm not really liking these photos right here. I'm going to go ahead and delete, delete, delete. Now these photos have been deleted. However, if I go back into my original folder, you'll see that I now have a rejected folder. And this way, if for whatever reason you want to bring those back and recover them, you can. Once I've deleted all the really bad ones, I will then go through and start rating them. I don't use like number 2, 3, 4, 5. That's too much for me. I use either 5 stars. Those are photos that I want to be buried with. Or I'll use 4 stars for photos that are really good, just not the ones I want to be buried with. But it doesn't matter how I do it. What matters is that you can apply color and numerical ratings to these photos, and then those will carry over when you bring them in to Lightroom or Capture One or whatever. They are added as a sidecar file. So one of the first things you want to do is go into preferences and go into XMP ratings and labels, and look at this. Your color labels can automatically be specified for Adobe defaults. Now, one thing that's default about this program that I don't like, but fortunately you can change that, is the fact that you cannot just hit a number key to rate a photo that number. For example, if you see a photo and you want to hit 5 to rate it a 5-star, it's Option 5 on a Mac or Alt 5 on a Windows machine. However, this is so easy to fix. Just go into File, Customize, Keyboard Shortcuts, go down to XMP Rating, and change these so that they are numbers. You see that right there? So now, as I go through the photos, I'm just hitting the number on the keyboard as I'm going through them. And if you don't see a grid view like I have here, press the G button on your keyboard and it switches from grid view to this other view. So I'll give this one 5 stars, and as I'm going through, I'll give this one 5 stars, maybe that one 4 stars. Now that I've finished rating them, let me show you what they look like in Lightroom. Okay, go up to Attribute and 4 stars and above, and look at that! And obviously with these colors right here, had I used the color coding way of ranking these files in here, would have carried over as well. This is really handy because you can quickly go through the files, make sure that you've deleted all the ones you don't want, mark all the ones 5 stars, 4 stars, whatever, and then all that information gets brought into Lightroom and ready for you. Now, there's a number of additional features on this program that I'm not going to cover today, but you might want to check out as they may help you in your workflow. For example, you have a histogram here that actually reads the raw file and not the JPEG preview that's embedded in the raw file. You are looking at the actual highlights and shadow details as represented in the raw file itself. And there's a whole bunch of tutorials on how to use this with this program. I will have a link to those down below. Another thing you can do, obviously, is hit Z, zoom in, and check your focus if you want to. Another thing you can do to check focus is pull up the peaking edge details view. Hit the P button on your keyboard, and it will show you various peaking and focus indicators. For example, it shows you the contrast details right here, or the fine focus details. So for example, this photo right here is more in focus than this one right here. You can also view in different channels as well, the red, green, and blue channel. I have barely touched the surface of what the raw histogram and the exposure stats can show you and how you can use them. Again, this is not a tutorial today on it. And I think it's pretty clear that if you need to go through a lot of raw files quickly and you want some way to cull through them, to rate them, to delete certain files, and then to bring that information into Lightroom, this is an outstanding program to do that. So how does Fast Raw Viewer stack up against Photo Mechanic 6? Well, I use Photo Mechanic 6 all the time. And frankly, both programs can do more or less of the same thing with regard to my workflow. If you're a sports photographer, particularly if you're sending photos out to AP, Reuters, and you need a lot of those advanced features that Photo Mechanic has to offer, I would say absolutely Photo Mechanic is the way to go. However, if you're a Fujifilm RAW shooter and you're not in professional sports photography or something that needs a fast RAW turnaround workflow, then I think Fast Raw Viewer would be definitely something you should check out. Because at the end of the day, Photo Mechanic is $139. Fast Raw Viewer is $24. However, I love both of those programs, and I would recommend either one to anyone serious about culling through quickly and processing their RAW files. Well, it is absolutely that time again. We have a new Geariguana Hall of Fame member, Luann Thatcher. Luann, thank you so much for supporting this channel and being a part of Backstage. And now, without any further ado, let's get your name on the studio wall. Well, Luann, there it is right there. Just out of frame, but it's on the studio wall forevermore in the Paldetech studio. Thank you so much for your support. It means the world to me. And for the rest of you, if you've not yet checked out Paldetech Backstage, what are you waiting for? We have all kinds of fun back here, starting with Monday morning coffee time. We're adding a Paldetech Discord server and growing a great community. And back to the show. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found the video helpful, or at least... Why am I pointing here? I didn't even say it yet. Okay. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you found the video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I am going to be signing off now. Have a wonderful weekend, and I will see you in another video next week. Take care.